another random haul. Well, actually, I'm just finished filming the first part, which you will probably have seen a couple of days ago if you're, like, you know, subscribed to my channel. Charity shop staff, let me see, B&M staff, Sainsbury's sale, I think I've got something from eBay, and I've got jewellery and stuff from the charity shop in here. So just a kind of muddled up thing. I'm going to aim to do, I do not have a timer, as I said before, I'm going to aim for about 10, maybe 15 minutes per segment, so however many videos that takes me to clear all this stuff, it might just be two more. Anyway, let's get started. The last video I was going through some of this, so let's finish off going through the stuff that's in here. I picked up quite a few jewellery bits. This was one of the nicer ones. This was in a little glass cabinet, and it didn't have the price on it, which made me think because it was in a glass cabinet it was going to be crazy dear, but it actually wasn't crazy dear. It came with a little box. This was only £2. It's really nice. It looks like it's real silver, but it's not real silver. It looks like, I don't know where to hold it, so you can see it. It's like a band and it sort of crisscrosses over, but it sits really, really nice on your finger. Like, it just, I don't know, there's something about it just, yeah, I don't know if you can see it next to this one. Hold on, I'll take this one off. I can get it off. Can I get it off? Yes, I can. There we go. It just sits really nice on the finger. It's like dainty, but kind of eye-catching as well at the same time. I really, really like that, and it was £2, so I may as well just leave it on now. Anyway, £2, and it came with a wee box. This I got, it's argan oil. It's from the brand Natural Extracts. It's argan oil lip balm, and it's never been used. I'd be a bit funny about buying lip balms and stuff, but obviously you can tell there's not one single mark in it. And this was only 10 pence, so got that to try. You can't go wrong with lip balms because I tend to use lip balms quite a lot and put them on at night time. This, I had never seen one like this before. It kind of looks like it's going to be a foldable mirror, but it's not. This is 25 pence, and it's one of those things that takes the lint off your clothes. I think there's some fluff left on there, like this. So it's like one of those things like that you, I don't even like the feeling of that, but it's one of those things you clean your clothes with. And but I thought because it folded up to this size, it would be good to put in your handbag. If you know, sometimes you just get some clothes that are just fluff magnets and you really, really love them, but that puts you off wearing them. I thought this would be good for that type of thing. Like, you know, you maybe get a black dress on, or you know, you don't want, you've got like little dog hairs or little cat hairs on it, and just to get it off and keep it in your handbag if you see any wee bits of fluff on you. So got that. Next thing is jewellery. I'm really into like stacking up jewellery. Like, I don't know, I like layers, you know, like several different bangles on. Kind of hippie, kind of like. This reminded me of a sort of hippie style. This was £1. And no, sorry, this was 50 pence actually. Bracelets were 50 pence in that shop. It looks like it's three separate bracelets. So like a little pleated one with a bead on it, and then one here with beads and a little leave on it. And it's just really pretty, and you can adjust it to the size of your wrist because I've got really tiny wrists. So that works out well for me. And it looks like you've done that stacking thing, but you've not. It's actually all just the one bracelet. I mean, you could add another bracelet to that if you wanted, but you've got that look just in one bracelet, and it was 50 pence. And it's got that burgundy, it's like got it's leather, and the leather, it's like burgundy around the middle, and it's got like a kind of burgundy stone, which is good for me because I'm majorly attracted to burgundy as like for clothing, and I've got a burgundy handbag in there. Anyway, attracted to burgundy, so that's nice because it's nice to have jewellery that's kind of tones in with what you're wearing. This I got, it caught my eye, it's a little bit tacky. This was 50 pence as well because the bracelets were all 50 pence. This still had its little tag thing on it and stuff, so I'm assuming it's new. And it's just got little gemstones all the way around it of all different colours. And I thought that would be a good way to just add a bit of, I have to wear it kind of because my wrists are really small, so that it would just slide off. So when I wore it just slightly up, and you can't see it on it. I wore it higher up in my arm anyway because I've got little wrists, and I just thought, I don't know if you're seeing the colours in that properly, but it's got lots of different colours in it, and I thought it would be nice to wear, and I've worn it a couple of times. Next thing is this. I'm calling this my jelly cube ring because it literally looks like a cube of jelly, you know, like before you melt it, and it's plastic. I really like these rings. Like, I don't know, it's like a big statement ring, and they're plasticky and kind of look like something you would get out of a kid's lucky bag, but I really, really like them, and it's in this orange colour. I just liked it because it was like a cube of jelly. Alexander told me to get this. I was looking at a load of rings, and Alexander said, get that one, Mum, it's like lava. So I got that to keep him happy, but Other people said it looked like a, my grand said it looked like a cube of jelly, and now that's all I can see every time I look at it. And all the rings were £1. That was in a different charity shop, and the rings were £1. Let me see, I've got so many rings. This one's got my hair all over it. As does most things. This one, to me, looks, it's got like a gothic type look to it. And the silver in it almost look, I'm doing that over to the screen thing when I should be doing that over to the lens. It's got the black stone in it, and then what looks to me like kind of spider webs. I really like this, and it was £1, and it's very kind of gothic-y looking, and I wear quite a lot of, quite like a big statement ring. I don't wear a lot of statement necklaces. I did get that kind of chunky necklace, but I don't usually wear, in fact, a lot of times I don't wear a necklace, but I do like a big chunky ring. I go from one extreme to another, either really dainty and pretty, or really, really in-your-face chunky. There's this, it's got a black stone in it, and but this is the gold, and it's got sort of detail around the side, and that was £1 for that one. Let me see, I think we're over at the end of the jewellery. This one I really liked because it was really different. It's got little beads on it, but the little beads move round on it, and it's good if you're a fidgeter because you can just sit and play with the little beads on it. It's got little blue beads, and it's silver. And it's weird because it's on a sort of, it's like a coil type thing. I don't know, it caught my eye. It was a, no, that wasn't, that was the same. That was, this was 50 pence. I think it was in the same one that got the bracelets. Oh my goodness, I must be nearly coming to the end. Mark bought me this one. This was £1 for this, and it's a little frog. Because you know, I like little frogs. And it's just a bit, this is definitely a kid's ring. Because it's, I nearly dropped it there. It's adjustable. And I don't know, there's just, there's something that about frogs with little cute faces I like, so he got me that, and I will definitely wear it. This I got again with that kind of hippie vibe. It's got a half penny, so it's got like an actual real, like a real coin. It's a half penny, and then over the half penny it's got like a, what do you call that, peace sign? Is it the peace symbol type thing there, like that, and it sits over it, and it's just looks like hammered kind of brassy goldy coloured beads, like an antique gold kind of colour, and I really like this one. I've worn this several times and I really do really like it. This one goes well with that leather one as well. Look, it looks nice for the stacking up thing. Right, we're nearly done with jewellery. We are nearly done with jewellery. I think we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 more rings, but these are not very, I'll go through the rings quickly. You're probably bored of jewellery already. This has got like a cream coloured stone, and then the back of it is stretchy, so it's on a, it's like got elastic kind of through the back like that, so it's stretchy, and it's got the cream thing there, and again it's just a big sort of statement ring. We see I've created another pile, I'm just waiting for it to topple over. This one, this is big, this is a big ring. I've got it on with that ring, so just ignore the other ring, but look how high that comes off your finger. It's a very, very, very big ring, and it's kind of browny kind of colour, but when the light hits it, it kind of looks like it changes colour from like yellow to brown. I like that. Next one is this. I've worn this one a few times and I really like it. I don't know if it's going to pick up, but it looks like it changes colour as well. It's a really odd kind of ring. It's green, very statementy ring, but I really liked it because it, see the way the light catches it, it kind of changes colour. Anyway, really like that. They were all £1 I think for those rings. No, I tell a lie, the plastic ones, those little like, plastic ones I just showed you were 50 pence, and the metal ones were £1 because they were in different places. This is just a tiny little ring with a little black stone in it, and this only is only fits in my pinky, so it's a little pinky ring. It's very, very small. It's probably like a wee kid's ring or something, but really like that. Just for a little bit extra, you could even wear other rings and then just have a, that one on your pinky, or just have it on your pinky by itself. Right, we are done with everything in this bag. This bag was from the charity shop also. This is £1.50 and it's like a toilet bag, and if you saw the video I've had before, I already took a lot of stuff out of it, and then I just took that stuff out of it. So this holds a lot of stuff, like a lot of stuff. It's by the brand Pretty Sporty. It's needing a good wash, so I'm going to put it through the, it's a bit like sort of grubby on the front, so I'm going to put it in the washing machine now that I've emptied all the stuff out of it. It's got a pouch in the front. Oh, it's Velcro. It's got a Velcro pouch on the front, and then no pouches on the inside. It's just like a, you know, where the wire's around it, so it opens like that and stays open. So it's a really handy travel bag, and it's a really good size, and I really like this feeling. It's very soft, and I don't know, I liked it, so I thought it would be a good toilet bag, travelling kind of bag. Oh my goodness. Right, next This I got in Oasis. Oasis is a shop I don't even think I've ever been in before, to be honest. And they had it in the shopping centre where my gran stays. You know, like up in the town, she stays in a village, but in the town nearest her, they had an Oasis. And when we were there, my auntie Pamela wanted to go and have a wee look. And so obviously I went and had a look and I bought two things. I bought this and I bought a pair of shoes. So I'll show you them both together. This was in the sale. It's actually, I have actually worn this and it's got my stuff in it. But it's just lovely. I did not realise that it comes with this gold chain. Very long gold chain. So it's like a mixture of gold and silver, because the bag is very much silver, but all the hardware on the bag is gold. So it's good because it'll go with any kind of jewellery you want to wear. It's got the flap on the front, the stud flap on the front. And I didn't realise, that's what I was going to say, I didn't realise that it's leather. It says it on the little Oasis tag and it's leather. And I got this for, I do not have the price tag for it, but I think it was £13. It was either £12 or £13. And it was originally, I can't remember, but probably about £25 or £30. But it's a really nice, like, going out bag, like a wee, if you're going out for dinner or, you know, whatever, just general goings out. And you can take the strap off it and just have it as a little clutch, and it's got a little wrist strap for you to hold it. You can actually fit, although it looks very small and flat, you can actually fit a lot of stuff in it. It looks almost like worn, kind of metallic-y, but it feels really, really nice. And I really, really like that. That was on sale. They had a pretty good sale on in there, actually. But not a shop I've ever shopped in before. I wore these when I was at my gran's. These are, I don't know what you call these when they're like, is it a sandal if it like goes up? Because it's not a boot, but it's not, I don't know what you call them, but whatever. I should have fastened them so I can show you better. These were on sale. I got these for, I'm guessing again, but it was around, I know they were less than £15. I think these might have been £13 or £14, but they were originally like £38 or something. So it was a really good deal. It's got a little wooden heel like that. Not a really high heel, so really easy to walk in. And then your foot shows through this bit, and then it obviously ties at the ankle and your toes show there. So definitely a summer type sandaly boot type. I don't know what you want to call them, I really don't, but I really like them. And these go with so many things. Like, they could go with jeans, just everything, dresses, everything, shorts. They just look really nice with everything. So got those. Next thing, a bit weird, a bit random, it's got the paper on it. You know, one of those, oh, it's came off. Is that broke? I think this might have broke. Oh no, I think it's broken. It's one of those invisible bras. I've literally bought this from the charity shop and it was in a box, but because I was travelling back from my grand's, I was trying to like narrow everything down, but like get out of packaging and hangers and stuff for stuff. So I took this out of its original box. It's one of those invisible bras. It kind of looks like chicken fillets, but it's not chicken fillets. Like one of those, it's just basically a cup, and you're meant to put that. I was just about to demonstrate and then realised how inappropriate that would be. Thank goodness I stopped myself there. Anyway, invisible bra, so if you're wearing a dress or something, maybe backless, that you can't wear a bra with, put that on so you just feel like a bit secure, and it attaches there. Except I've broken it. I don't know how I've managed to do that, and I don't know that it would be fixed. They're made kind of sticky, so you take that, like the backing off, and then stick them on and attach that. And I don't know, I'm probably not going to be able to wear them now that they're, unless I can somehow fix that. It is, and they were about £2 something, I think. Another thing, these are from the Sains, I keep wanting to say Superdrug every time I say Sainsbury's sale. They were £7 and half off, so I got them for £3.50, which I thought was a pretty good deal. I'm obsessed with slippers. I've got far too many pairs of slippers, but I absolutely love them. And I also, I'm not one of those people that keep their slippers till they're like, I know some people who just can't throw their slippers away. They're super comfy, and but they're all like grubby and stuff. I don't like wearing them when they're all grubby, so I wear them to a certain point to start. And I also put them in the washing machine, but once they start not coming up well, when they come out the washing machine, I get rid of them. So I do go through them, but I do have too many slippers, I must admit. But these look nice and cute. They kind of look like a, I don't know, like the slides you get for going out, you know, like that's not a slipper. They've got the wee knotty bit of material there, and they're all furry on the inside, so I think these will be really, really comfy. I'm pretty sure there's another pair of slippers in here. There is. I may as well just show you them now. There's one. I'm not sure where the other one is. It might be beside it. I don't know. This, I think, is a slipper. I've actually washed this. It's been through my washing machine, and I've worn them. It's a satiny material. You could probably wear this outside. I mean, the soles are pretty hard, so you probably could wear it outside, but I did buy them. They are slippers, and I did buy them as slippers. And they're just nice and soft, satiny. And I thought they would be good. Like, they're not the big, I've got big, huge unicorn ones, and I wouldn't like, and they're soft in the bottom, but like if you're wanting to go and hang the washing out or something, I wouldn't need to change into a pair of shoes. I could just wear these that are from taking the bin out or whatever. They're more like a going out in slipper, if that makes sense. Like, probably that makes no sense. But anyway, I got those and these were £2. So that. Oh, this is from Primark. See how muddled up it is? One charity shop, one whatever. Sainsbury's Primark. This is from Primark. It was originally £6 and I got it on sale for £3. And it's one of those... Oh, sorry. Something stuck in my throat. Yeah, I've wanted to try this for ages. I'm trying not to hold it against me so that you can see. It's one of those ones, you know, that's got all the design at the front. Instead of having like the fanciness or the straps or whatever at the back, it's got all the design. If I hold it there, can you see? Yeah, that's better. So it's got all the design at the front of it. So if you wear like a little top, it just adds a bit of interest here. I'm not sure, I'm going to be honest, I'm not sure if I'm going to like it. And I probably wouldn't have bought it if it was full price. But for £3, I thought I can give it a go and see if I actually like it. But I don't know if that would irritate me or not. I don't know. Well, we'll give it a go. So there's that. Oh my goodness. This I got from eBay. It's originally from H&M, but it wasn't second hand. It was like from a shop that was selling, I don't know if it's like X stock or I don't know what it is, but it was brand new. And yeah, it's from H&M and it's just this. I've opened it up to try it on. I should have fastened it back up again. It's just a check shirt, basically. I just typed in flannel shirt to eBay and up popped this and I really liked it. And it was something like, I think it was like £6.69 or something. It was under £7. It's a really nice soft cotton one and I really like that colour for the winter. Getting prepared for winter coming, so got that. I really love check shirts. Oh, sorry, itchy nose. There's that thing again. I said that last time. I think I get nervous and get an itchy nose. This Mark picked me up. It's from the charity shop and it was £5.99. In fact, there was a story behind that. It's not here, I don't think. But inside this was £5.99, which is, you know, not too pricey, but not too cheap either. But inside it, they had stuffed, oh, there's something that irritated me. A cat or dog here, I think. Got it. Anyway, yes, £5.99, but they had stuffed it with a like, plastic bag so that it kept its shape. And inside the plastic bag was a little River Island, I think it was River Island, blue, you know, like little cami top thing. And I love little cami top things. So I got a free top with it. It was inside one of the bags that were inside that. So this, for £5.99, I got the bag and a little vest top. So there's that. It's a Juicy Couture bag. It's kind of like velvet, not velvet. Is it velvet? Sort of velvet, but not velvet. Like, it doesn't give me a funny feeling, and velvet gives me a funny feeling. So I got that. Let me see on the inside. On the inside, it's kind of cute because it's got this little mirror. I thought that was really cute. And it's got little pouches, and it's got a little bit for your keys, and it says Juicy all over the bag. It does, however, not come. This is heavy, like really heavy, the hardware in this. This gigantic ring, like it's got a massive ring on it, and this is really, really heavy. I do not usually, I mean, it would fit over your arm like that, but I do like it. I like the option of a crossbody. So what I was going to do, these are black straps, and what I was going to do is take the black straps off one of my other bags and put it onto this bag, because you could certainly attach it through these hoops and make it a crossbody bag, perhaps, maybe, I don't know. I really liked it, and it was £5.99, and it's got a lot of, oh, that's all little jewels. Chain there's got little jewels in it as well. There's a lot of detail in it. I like it. This is brown. Handles are black. Like that. Right, let me see. Another bag. This I used. This might be a bit dirty. This is still got its original tag on it. It doesn't say the price, however. It just says Equilibrium. And this is like a hippie sort of type bag. It's got the elephant on it. Design around there. The back of it's just plain. It's got these big chunky rope straps. This was £2.50 and I just love it. This is from the charity shop. I should have said that. Is there something in it? No, there's. Oh, and there is something in it. I'm like, what's in that? Travel sickness pills. I do not travel well at all and I was in the car, so travel sickness pills essential. They must have been left over since that. But it's a good size bag and it's good for just chucking a whole load of stuff in no particular order. And it holds a lot, and I had crisps and sweets and snacks in it and a blanket, and it really does hold a lot, so I can see myself using that quite a bit. Another thing I got from Sainsbury's half price, I think that was generally it was either half price or more, which I thought was pretty good. This was originally £8, it was down to £4. This, I wish I could go through the screen. It says here that it is like crazy soft material. It says soft touch. And it says on the little thing about how soft it is, they're not lying. It is super soft. It's that like bouncy. Oh, just, I wish you could feel it. It almost blends in with my wall. I wish you could feel it. It's nothing fancy. It's literally just not, it's not 3/4 length and it's not too short. Like, it's slightly longer than just an ordinary t-shirt, like the sleeve. And turns up, I just got it because it was soft. I literally, it's not the colour, it's not the style. It just, it could have been anything and I would have bought it just based on this material because it's so, so, so soft. So I'm looking forward to wearing this. So there's that. There's quite the mountain piling up inside of me. Right, next I got, we'll finish this one, finish this basket down here so I don't need to keep leaning down. I got these, they're both the same actually, so I don't really need to show you the two of them. It's these, it's a traditional lace single panel voile. I got these for my bedroom. These were $8.99 each and they're just literally, they're like old fashioned net curtains basically, except they call them lace and it sounds a bit fancier than net curtains, but I love lace. And they've got scalloped, I don't know if you can see it, where is it? They've got scalloped bottoms. But where it's going to go in my bedroom, you're probably not going to get to see that anyway. But has it scalloped bottoms? Maybe it doesn't. Maybe I'm talking rubbish. I don't know. It doesn't seem to. Anyway, I just thought they'd be really pretty and give my bedroom like a kind of... Well, that went weird colour there. Sorry about that. Is it because I was maybe too close to the camera? I don't know. Colour just seemed to go weird there. Anyway, $8.99 lace curtains for my bedroom. I thought it would give it a like romantic-y kind of look. Right. Last thing from this video, and then I think I might move on to another video so that I'm not taking up too much of your time, is this. I picked it up in Primark. It was £2.50 and I'm going to use it as a makeup bag, like not a makeup bag as in like for all your makeup, but if you're just going out and you want like your lip gloss and whatever and maybe a little powder or something to touch up with, it's got knobbly bits on it and it's just, it's made of like that silicone, and I'm a very tactile person. I like the feel of stuff. And I just like the feel of that, and it's got little bobbles all over it, and I quite like the colour as well, and it's got a little thing like that, I don't know, as if you would use it as a clutch, I don't know, but I really liked it, so there's that. I think I'm going to end it here and carry on and film another video. You'll be sick of seeing me in this top, because literally the next three videos are going to be me sitting in this top, so I'm sorry about that. But I didn't want to leave you too long, and you know what I'm like, if I leave it, I won't film it, so I thought, sit down, film them all, do it all right now so that I don't let you down and they're going to be up. So I think that is what I'm going to leave at just now. I still got a lot of stuff, and that basket's emptied in there, but I still got a lot of stuff in this one, so I'm going to get going and film that video, and I will see you guys very, very soon. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.